Thank you, TJ. Welcome, and everyone here. It's a pleasure to be here on this nice day. I'm here to unveil the plaque of the Martin Luther King Jr. Peace Garden. First, on a personal note, I would like to congratulate TJ and best wishes to he and Sylvia on their recent marriage.
Thank you.
I was introduced to TJ last May. He is one of the warmest, most peaceful people I've ever known, and it's a privilege to have an opportunity to know you. Later, I met Sylvia. She was here for the ceremony and was as nice. Further congratulations, TJ, for your honor being bestowed on you in Washington next week. TJ, when looking for a noun for peace, it would be you, and I say job well done. As president of the Atlanta Women's Club, which celebrates its 120th anniversary this week, often I am asked to attend events, and my only thoughts are to be a representative of the club, for which I cherish its past and future. However, last night, in trying to think of what I was going to say, it occurred to me. This is personal for me. So, not only did I think of the legacy of the Atlanta Women's Club, but my own personal life. And frankly, to make sure my granddaughter and future members such as her would cherish what we do today. When I read the speech to my granddaughter this morning, gratefully, I gestured my fingers at certain points, and she told me to stop. I told her she was right. My mother, grandmother, and certainly Mrs. Raff David Abernathy, who was one of my ultimate examples of ladylike behavior, would not appreciate the gesturing. So, I am a native Atlantan. My family had businesses on Auburn Avenue. My grandfather was an insurance agent and worked in the surrounding areas. I even recalled being in a parade along with other children wearing a t-shirt that said, "My dad is a legionnaire," on Auburn Avenue. And sadly, I attended the funeral of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. in the church across the street. So you can imagine when thinking this through, it became quite personal and more than laying a plaque. So thank you all for giving me this opportunity to advance peace and understanding amongst all nations, cultures, and religions of the world through the creation of rose gardens that become magnets to community activities. This is the mission of the International World Peace Rose Gardens. You would think peace and nonviolence is outdated both domestically and internationally. But it is not. Certainly the idea and the struggle for peace continues. In addition, we are called to be socially and environmentally conscious. I would like to encourage you not only to come to this garden on a regular basis, but visit the other 8 gardens throughout the world. Again, thank you and peace.
Peace.
Okay, you hit the button.
Thank you. Action.
Did you get a picture of the plaque?
And here is the plaque.